Hello and welcome to another Use IP video. In this week's video we'll be looking at different storage options and which option is the best for your camera setup. We understand that storage can be expensive and it's also annoying if you make the wrong decision and either don't have enough space or waste money on too much space. So to help you figure it out, we're going to take you through the pros and cons of the three most popular storage options. These are SD card, network and cloud. Now that's out of the way, let's get going with our first storage option. SD card. For years, the option of recording to an SD card was only, apart from a few rare examples, available from commercial brands. But it is now gradually becoming the norm for all IP cameras to feature a micro SD card slot. And with the max storage size of micro SD cards always increasing, to the point where most IP cameras can now take up to 128GB on a single card, they are definitely an option to be taking seriously. And so from the outside, they seem like a great option for a small system. And that's absolutely true, but obviously they do have their limitations. For example, recordings on an SD card can only be accessed either by physically removing the card from the camera and inserting it into a card reader, or by logging into each camera on your system individually, but both of these options are fiddly and time consuming. Another potential problem is that because the recordings are stored on board, if a person caught committing a crime by the cameras decides to destroy it or tries to steal the evidence, you'll be left without any evidence as the footage won't be backed up to a cloud or network storage space. But if you're only installing a small system of 1 to 4 cameras that are indoors or vandal-proof and you want to save some money, then micro SD cards are a perfectly acceptable option. Your second storage option is cloud storage. Now, cloud storage is a much better option if you're wanting to keep your camera footage secure, as it will be stored in an industrial cloud server like Amazon Cloud or Dropbox. These servers are designed with fail-safes and security measures that mean there is almost zero chance of you losing any of your data. As well as the security measures, cloud services are often very user-friendly and also easily accessible from anywhere in the world as long as you have an internet connection. But again, just like micro SD cards, cloud storage has its own problems, the biggest being the cost. This is because all good cloud services will charge if you want to store more than a few gigabytes. And with IP cameras, you're going to need a lot of space. For example, 4 4-megapixel cameras recording for a week will use around 1.6 terabytes of space. So obviously, if you're paying for that amount of space every month, you're going to be spending a fortune. On top of this, if you're going to be using cloud services with IP cameras, make sure your camera brand is compatible with your chosen cloud service before investing in any space. This is because some IP brands will require you to install video management software, which you might also have to pay for, to view and manage your footage. So in the end, we would advise against using cloud storage with IP cameras, unless you're only recording to a single camera at low resolution, and if the IP brand you've chosen has its own cloud servers, such as EasyViz. The third and final option is network storage. This, in our opinion, is the best option if you want a storage option that is customizable to the requirements of your system. Now, network storage comes in two main types. One is NAS devices, which are general network storage devices, which can be used to store both IP camera footage and general files, video, music, etc. The second option is an MVR, which is designed purely as an IP camera recording device and allows you to access all your cameras and their features in one place. Just from those descriptions alone, you get a good idea of what makes network storage such a good option. Multi-purpose storage, viewing all your cameras in one place, and a variety of models for systems of all sizes. In the end, there aren't really that many big negatives to network storage. The only one that will really put you off as a customer is price. Now, it is true that most professional brand network storage devices are £100 plus, but with all the extra features and the removal of the recurring payments found with cloud storage, it is a worthwhile investment. In most cases, we advise people to spend a little bit more and buy an MVR or NAS that is capable of handling slightly more cameras than they currently own, as to allow for their system to expand in the future. This is much harder to do with micro SD or cloud storage, so tricky in fact that most people who use micro SD or cloud storage will come back to us and ask to upgrade to an MVR or NAS because of their versatility. Also, on top of the price of the box, you will have to purchase separate hard drives to install in the MVR or NAS. Now, this does drive the cost up, but with many hard drive sizes available, it does again make them a much more versatile option when it comes to expanding your system in the future. In the end, the final decision is yours, and we only made this video as guidance as to what might suit your needs, and hopefully we got the pros and cons of all three options across clearly. And if you wish to know any more about the difference between MVRs and NASs, you can check out our other video, which is linked here in the top right of this video and in the description below. Thank you for watching and subscribing. If you haven't subscribed already, please do by clicking down here. Check out the description below for links to our Facebook, Twitter and Google+. Follow the link here for our webshop. And if you want more videos like this, check out the playlist up here. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.